this is the inside of the pump. I've just cleaned it up a bit, and you can see these two teeth here engage with the inside of the torque converter, the shaft as it all mounts up. The cover's taken off. This is the cover plate. This is how the oil pump works. You've got this fixed bit here, which is part of the casting. This crescent here is part of this. You've got a free to spin gear. Can only go one way, sort of. And then as the engine turns, you can see the teeth coming out of mesh and then coming into mesh here. As it's doing that, it's squeezing the fluid. And of course, you get pressure is all about pressure difference. Basically, a pump causes a pressure change across the pump. So you get low pressure, high pressure. There's probably some laminar flow and turbulent flow funkiness going on, but basically a pump causes a pressure difference. And right here, look at the way it's finely machined. Sorry, if I just show you. Just there, look at that. It's very clever. So yeah, this is spinning at a lot of, depending on what gear you're in, obviously. So it's just doing a few thousand RPM. And then this is turning like that. There's some engine oil pumps that are very similar, and power steering pumps and other hydraulic pumps. Others use two gears in mesh. This one, like I say, it's like a concentric arrangement with this part of the casting. And right, and then as you imagine, there's channels here, there's a flat plate here, so fluid is distributed through various orifices at high pressure, which then go on to the valve block, and from the valve block to the rest of the transmission. So that's how a hydraulic pump, because it is a hydraulic pump, on a gearbox, on a automatic gearbox works. Very nicely machined. Right, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.